Hey guys, this is Kevin Liptak with Refresh Advertising here for the very first time with the Oculus Quest. We're going to do a quick unboxing, see what's inside. It's like Christmas. Come in and take a look. All right, let's see what we have here. So we've got our Quest headset there. Nice, good weight. A little bit heavier than the Go, but got a nice rigid head wrap. Right. Very similar to the Go or the Rift. Put that down for a second, right? We've got our two hand controllers here. Punch in on these suckers. So we've got our charger, pulled up there. We've got an additional faceplate. I'm assuming based on when we unpackaged the Go that they had a separate faceplate for those of you with glasses. So this is probably it, although we'll make sure to read the manual and check. Came with batteries, already set to go for the controllers, reference guide, and a nice pocket manual and warranty. All right guys, so we took a quick minute to check out some of the external features on the headset, and we'll punch in a little bit and I'll show you some of those. So we've got our four sensors built into the headset right here. 1, 2, 3, 4. We've got power button is now here on the side. Okay. If you look here now at the bottom, unlike the other wireless, the Oculus Go, where the controls were up here on the top, they are now down here on the bottom. You've got the plus and minus here for the volume control. You also have another cool feature here, a little lever that moves side to side, and you can see inside there it adjusts the lenses to the bridge of your nose, so you're going to get a better, clearer picture depending upon the size of your face. All right, another quick couple things to note. It's got a little bit of a harder, it's got a hard rubber strap around the outside. It's still very flexible, but it's not the cloth strap that came with the Go. Quick and easy adjustment, slides in and out right to your head, right, both sides. And then right here, you can see this is our charging port in there for connections. And then we'll put it on for feel. So I'm comparing this to the Go just because we've used that a lot here, and you know, comparing a wireless to a wireless headset is probably the easiest way to go. It definitely feels a lot more secure on your face than the Go. I guess that has a lot to do with the strap. It's kind of formed to the back of your head, and it kind of keeps a little bit higher on the top of your head, and the headset is a little bit heavier than the Go, so I guess they want it to kind of almost let it hang down a little bit onto your face. But it swings. You can kind of pull it in and out, swing it up, swing it down. Gets a nice tight feel on your face. Little bit of gap down here. Let a little bit of light in. I think you can probably fix that by adjusting with the bridge of your nose here. Pulling it down on your face. But all in all, a little heavier. It's got a lot more components in than the Go, but still pretty secure, fairly light, easy to move around. Can't wait to power up.